and welcome back to Proactive Investors. Joining me now from Nova Minerals is CEO Christopher Gerteisen. Chris, great to have you back in the studio with us today. Trust you're keeping well.
I am. Great to be with you, Elisha.
So Chris, let's talk about the latest headlines for Nova. Obviously, that 9.9 million ounces of contained gold at the Estelle Gold Project in Alaska is a big one for you guys. Walk us through this achievement.
Big milestone for us. So as you might know, last year we completed an additional 30,000 meters of drilling. And now we've finally been able to incorporate that into our resource and come out with our latest MRE, resource estimate. And so the results are an increase in the global resource estimate for the Estelle Gold Project from 9.6 to 9.9 million ounces. And also significantly, an increase in the measured and indicated portion of that from 3 to 3.4 million. And importantly, most of that increase in the measured and indicated portion comes from our RPM deposit in the south, which is our very high grade deposit. 340,000 ounces in measured and indicated resources now at an average grade of 2.3 grams per ton. Previously, that resource was all inferred. And so now we've proved that up into the measured and indicated category, which will be very, very significant in terms of what that means for our upcoming scoping study.
Speaking of that, I believe that's on track for release this quarter. Is that right?
Correct. So now that the resource update is complete, check. Next step is the phase two scoping study. And if your viewers follow our story and recall, last year we came out with a phase one scoping study which looked at our Corbell deposit alone. However, this year, it will also include the high-grade RPM resource. And so we're working diligently with our independent consultants in the background to release this. I'm hoping, and we're working towards the end of April, but that could perhaps go into early May, but certainly in the coming weeks. That will come out. And I expect, all things being equal from phase one scoping study, a few tweaks here and there. But the only difference is now you'll be having 340,000 ounces of additional high grade material coming into those early years. And so that should bode very well for the key economic metrics like payback period and NPV, IRR, these kind of things. So people can keep us on your radar. That'll be coming out very soon.
I'm sure us and investors will check back in with you very shortly on that scoping study progress. But Chris, you mentioned there as well, a big component of this resource is measured and indicated ore. Tell us a little bit about how the further drilling programs are going to continue to continue the Estelle Gold story.
Right. So at RPM, that'll be the main focus of our upcoming 2023 drilling program. Because the measured and indicated portion we have there already, importantly, it's where it sits in its geometry. So it's like a high-grade core. It's a pod that's right on the surface, and it'll be early years production. It'll be part of a starter pit. My suspicion is it's expected to be the starter pit. So virtually 100% or pretty close to it, we'll convert to reserves eventually. And so obviously with something like that, that kind of potential, which we've already proven now at RPM, 90% of our efforts this year and this year's drilling program will be at RPM because it remains wide open. The RPM story isn't over. It's just getting started. And we plan an additional at least 15,000 meters this year to continue to prove up and find more of these high-grade bonanza zones. And then also our drilling programs this year we'll be going to the nearby Train prospect. And Train has shown itself to be potentially another one of these massive intrusive related gold systems. It's an RPM style target. We see very similar geology there. We'll put the first drill holes in it. And we expect and we hope that that'll be successful and we'll establish a third resource now at Estelle by the end of this year. So you'll have Corbell, RPM, and now Train. That'll be included to get us in the next resource update over that 10 million ounces. You know, we just came short this year, but we expect after this year's drilling program, we will be over 10 million ounces total global resource, with an additional increase in the measured and indicated portions as well, and hopefully more of that high grade RPM materials. So that's what people have to look forward to. You know, Elisha, so currently Nova Minerals, very, very undervalued. You could invest for $1,000. I was doing some calculations today. If you own 1,000 Nova shares, you have leverage to 48 ounces of gold total, right? Just the measured and indicated portion. If you owned 1,000 shares of Nova, you'd be exposed, have leverage to almost 16 ounces of very high confidence gold ounces. And so there you go, you know, so at current share price is like $350 and you're leveraged to 16 or 48 ounces of gold, depending on how you look at it. So that's pretty good value in my book.
Certainly good to hear about the bang you can get for your buck here. Now, Chris, just recapping here, plenty to keep you busy as you work towards that 10 million ounce milestone. Obviously, you've got the scoping study coming up, the drill bit keeps spinning, and you're looking potentially at another resource at Train as well. Tell us a little bit about the future you see for this project as well. I understand on the development front, you're also looking at some things on the road access front. Can you fill us in?
Sure. You'd be referring to the West Susitna Access Road. This project is gaining major momentum and getting widespread support across the spectrum of society here in Alaska, be it the state government. It's a state government project being fully funded now, the EIS process, which is going through now. The current schedule has that breaking ground, if all goes well with permitting, to be breaking ground on that road in 2025 and open for business by 2028, which fits pretty well into the Estelle timeline schedule on our path to production. And so what we're seeing now, as I said, $8.5 million that it's been funded through the EIS process by the state. They're looking to have some further funding in this year's budget for those early engineering works. The road goes from Fort McKenzie, that's the deep water port for Anchorage, the major city here in Alaska, and it extends out 100 miles to the West Susitna Mining District, which the Estelle Gold Project is part of. We're only one of many beneficiaries of this road, which is why it has so much support. That whole economic corridor is filled with economic opportunities, from agriculture to resource projects such as our own, to fire control, land sales, you name it. And the locals and their local support, community support, is widespread as well. They just recently did a poll. 60% of the local population in the Matsu borough here, that's like a council, I think in Australian terms, is in support of the road. Only 7% are not in favor of the road. And in that middle ground are people that just want to go, hey, there's a road, tell me more, right? And so fair enough. And so it's looking very good. And in all weather, all year round road like that, on the same schedule, basically, that we are on our path to production, is looking very positive in terms of getting the Estelle Gold Project up and running here in the very near future.
Mm. Good to hear that infrastructure is also in the pipeline, something that will help you as you move into production down the track as well. Nova Minerals CEO Christopher Gerteisen, thanks again for your time and filling us in on this important milestone.
Great to be with you, Alicia. We'll see you next time.